Hey there. Well, I picked this handyman special up on a almost steal. Could not resist. It's an MTD Yard Machines 18 horse 46 inch cut with the bagger unit. I got the rest of it there. And it was dirt cheap. It's got the Briggs & Stratton twin with the cast iron sleeve. That thing's almost indestructible. Runs like a charm. I'm not going to fire it up at the moment. I took a few things. I've already taken this cover off here and looked down the old battery chute, and I got a funny feeling I know exactly what's up with this thing. And it's just a matter of finding some parts. I'm going to drag this into the shop because it's nice and cool in there. It's only 66 degrees. And out here, it's 31. Can't believe that 8 days ago, this is March 14th. March 5th, oh, so almost 10 days ago, I still had snow. Not much, but, and now it's 31 degrees and I'm dying out here. So yes, you might notice videos kind of screwing up your time streams because they're going to be here, there, and everywhere. You might hear me bitching about the snow in the next video, but that was because it was done 3 months ago and been sitting in the computer ever since. But anyway, let me get this inside. Yeah, so I kind of lucked out with this machine. The gas cost more than the machine did, basically. It was a pretty long drive, but I wasn't going to pass it up. The bags are good, like just the bagging system alone. They're all good. There's one hole there, which is whoopee-doo. That can be fixed up so easily. And maybe one little rivet there or whatever, but in general, they're in beautiful shape. I don't know where my camera was pointing because I was looking one way and... So yeah, I got all that bagging stuff off of there for now. And let you get sick and watch my camera go wherever the hell it's going. I don't know if I can take this off one-handed or not. Anyway, strip that down a little bit. Okay, like I said before, I already had that cover off. And I have a rough idea of what's going on here. Basically, here my zoom. That is known as, I think, a variable speed pulley. And it takes two belts. Let me get out a bit. One goes on the bottom, heading that away, under motor. One goes on top, heading that away to the tranny. And if you look at it, it looks like two pulleys, but the center is one, and it slides up and down the shaft and accommodates for, I guess, the variable speed. But basically, that thing seems locked up tighter than a drum. So the deal with this, I don't really have to take this crap off, but because it looks like it comes off super easy, it's got like two screws with bolts on either side and then four bolts, I believe, and that should pop right off. Take the battery case out and then it'll open everything up and I'll be able to access things a lot easier. It can be done with the battery box out and reaching in and doing your yoga and the fingers or your gang signs or whatever to get things done, but we'll make some room. One thing to watch for when you're removing the back deck to these, the seat springs hold it all down as well. I thought they were just attached to like that, but they're right through. Long bolts. They were stiffer than a cunt's nut, and I just sprayed the living hell out of them. eked it a little bit, sprayed a little more, eked it a little bit, sprayed a little more, and let it sit. But I made sure I eked them a little bit and then sprayed, because that'll break it free enough for it to go sink in. And this is the double, it's this is the this stuff, you know what it is, but the brown bottle, not the blue. This stuff is amazing. Amazing. And of course I got to show you the French side first. There we go. It's really nice stuff. But now I can take the rear deck off. That was about, those two were the only real problem bolts I had. The other ones came up pretty good, though I did soak them with this first. Well, I kind of lucked out here. I was praising WD-40's brown formula, the specialist rust release. That stuff's amazing. I had sprayed the variable speed pulley here just to kind of loosen up any kind of rust that might be by the snap ring there. And this thing was seized, but look at this. Oops, I'm not even pointing. There we go. And look at this. It's not seized anymore. I took it out, just out front, and propped it up and fired it up. Kind of got a little car battery set up for now. Went through reverse and forward and six, well, not actually gears, but six speeds. And, yeah, so, that's bonus. Handyman special. Love it. Brain part. Oh, got to replace the belts, or one, actually. I checked out the lower drive belt and it's in pretty decent shape. The upper drive belt's crap, it's got to come off, but I should be able to get away with removing the belt and removing that pulley to service it. I have some needle bearings on the way, and I've also ordered a idler pulley. Where are we? Right there. Just because it seemed a little wobbly, so. But yeah, that's awesome. I thought that was going to be a real problem. It was seized up enough to smoke the belt, so I don't want to run it, because obviously if it was seized up that much, it's certainly probably pretty dry in there. Anyway, let me show you what I'm up to here. And I'll set the tripod up and just do it, but I suck at tripods and crap like that, because either I get in the way, my beard gets in the way, or whatever. But at least you'll have a rough idea what I'm up to. Now I'm going to take the top belt off. No need to take the transmission pulley off. There's just no reason. I've seen a few people do it, no reason. What I'm going to do to clear the belt is remove the bolts that are holding the shifter on, and pay attention to the wire, the springy thingy there. Shouldn't go anywhere. I'm upside down for you, aren't I? And that's these two. So I will remove them, and that lets that clear the belt around it. I've got the clutch off, got it in sixth, in neutral, that doesn't really matter, but I'll pull the pulley right on back, and actually I'll do that now, and just clear the belt. See how nice and floppy that is, and it'll come off here. Oh yeah, 7/16 bolt underneath. Where is my finger? guide pin there. There's a 7/16 access from the bottom. I dropped my deck so I can get down there. You see that better? Just gonna loosen it up so I can get the belt past it. Undo those two, because look, my belt's pretty much off. Actually, I'm gonna set the tripod. You know what I'm up to. I'm gonna loosen that. I'm gonna disconnect that, take the belt off. And voila, the belt is off. Nice. But yeah, belt's off. That didn't have to come off. No springs had to come off. The only thing that I didn't think of, your idler, maybe a fix it. Like I had to basically, I can't do it one-handed. Or can I? Basically, I had to move the idler arm this away so I could work with the belt to get it around. Can you see that? Anyway, belt's off. Bottom one should just kind of pop off once I put the clutch on. It should loosen the bottom belt considerably. I might be able to walk it off. I didn't remove that pin, but you can see it's wobbly, so I can get the belt past it. Mind you, that belt would have slid past it regardless. But putting the other one on, different story. Anyway, so yeah, I should be able to slide the belt off. The lower drive belt, without having to screw around that end. So I can take that pulley off by pushing in the clutch. That should relieve that enough. I should be able to walk it off, especially if I remove the clip and just kind of walk it off with the pulley. We'll see how it goes. Okay, I did end up taking that guide pin off. Be careful, there's a lock washer there as well. Probably going to be a bitch to get back on, but it made getting the pulley off a lot easier, and I was able to kind of walk the belt off as I came, and then when I put it back, I'll kind of walk the belt on. I was fortunate, the shaft's pretty good, it's not screwed up, I was lucky. I'm just going to sand just the top edge around, because a little of that surface rust kind of pulled through the needle bearings, which I'm changing anyway, but yeah. I don't want to screw them up when I put the new ones on. But other than that, worked out pretty good. Over to the bench. I'm just going to use a punch. And if you go down, you can feel the inside of the bearings. I'm not holding that in the vise. I'm just using the vise as a base. And then I just got a little peanut thingy to catch the bearings and all that. Give that a couple of taps around, flip it over, do the same to the other side, and we'll clean up the insides from there. One. You feel it moving, and you don't need to scrape the walls or anything. Just once you feel it moving, just kind of tap it. Boom. Okay, so bearings are out. We'll clean up the old goo that's in there. Now it's just a waiting game. I'll do some other stuff in the meantime, but when I get my parts in, I'll let you know a little more about this. Importantly, you want the disc to slide, be free, which I'm lucky this is. Check for debris. Can you see me? Check for debris in, see where that groove goes in. Make sure there's no debris in there so that the belt will travel in there to its full extent. There's a groove on each side, so, you know, clean that all up. I'll clean this all in, out with gasoline and rubber rag through and stuff like that. And then when the new bearings come, we'll go on from there. Just got my little wire or bottle cleaner here. Got a few of them, different sizes. Clean out the shop there. Okay, one other thing I'm going to do here is, it's a little rough on the pulley surfaces, so I'm just going to get some nice fine emery cloth and just take out the roughness, and the belts will smooth it all out after that, but I just don't want anything really chunking at them right off the bat. But other than that, we're all nice and clean. Waiting on my deliveries and some singing lessons. I polished that up a bit. Did 400 grit, 800 grit, and then finished off with some 2500 grit. Just basic, you know, it's a lawnmower, right? So, but it's nice and smooth. There's not, I don't think there'll be any issues. Now it's just a matter of waiting. I'll change the oil and stuff like that in the meantime. Maybe work on my deck. Yeah. Got my parts in. Got the idler pulley for the drive belt. And likely, if you've got a system similar to mine, that would be what you're looking for. I have a feeling that it is a fairly universal pulley, but, you know, double check. Got my needle bearings. And chances are as well, if you have needle bearings, because I've seen two styles. One is this style, the other has regular ball bearings. And these were the only ones I found. So that's the part number. I have checked them out with my old ones. Everything's copacetic. Ideally, he'd like a press to press these bearings in, but I don't have one. So basically what I'm going to be doing, so I got myself a piece of aluminum stock, just so that I don't damage the edges of the steel. My bench vise is pretty much exactly the right height for all of this. I'll set myself up, but essentially what I'm going to be doing is setting up my bearing nice and flush. I got this nice big washer that will, where am I? Oh. I got this big washer, and I'll attempt to press that bearing in. Dun, 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 dun. Let's see how she goes. Everything's pretty much lined up. Everything looks pretty straight on. And just nice and smooth. Looks good. Beauty. Now press that in so that it's nice and flush. And that should be that. And voila, can you see? And it's just below the line, which is perfect. Just gotta do that on the other side and good to go. And voila, both needle bearings pressed in. This I'm going to keep at the bottom because that's the shiny spot where it was spinning on a couple of brass washers or copper or something. So I'll keep that orientation. I was doing a couple kind of dry runs because at the moment I don't really want to get into pulling the front pulley. My lawn's getting a little crazy. And for some reason I can't get my other piece of crap going. And I don't want to push more of the whole place, so I just want to get this back out and ready to go. Oh, but I digress. What was I going to say? Getting old. Sometimer's disease. What's going on here? Oh yeah. So I did a couple of dry runs with this pulley. Just to see if I'm going to have any issues putting it back, because it was a little awkward taking it off, but totally doable, obviously. And basically, what I did is I pinched, one arm bandit. Anyway, basically I made sure the cup was up, the belt was in it, and I pinched it as tight, see that, just pinched it nice and tight. Now I'm talking that belt there, obviously, and all I really had to do to make it actually slide in fairly well, and I am remembering that there will be needle bearings in there, so it'll be a smaller diameter, but it popped in pretty nice, and all I had to do was lift this spring just up and out of the way, just so it would slide in a little better. It worked, you know, with both hands it works out pretty good, and then it just slides right on, and hopefully it'll work out well. Underneath this pulley on the shaft were these two washers. They look the same, I don't know, but I'm keeping them in the same order that they came. And I figure I'll put a little bit of bearing grease on them just to, Moving parts. Okay. I'm gonna slide those on the shaft there. And they'll bottom out at the bottom. And I got some grease underneath that as well. And try not to grease up my fingers too much. Wipe them down. I did do a couple trial runs without any bearings in it. That should go all right. Okay, here we go. First part is trying to get comfortable doing all this. So I'm keeping the shiny side down because that's how I found it. And keep that up. I am going to remove my glasses so I can almost see what's going on. Get that belt. Get it on that pulley. Squeezing that pulley down. Now try to figure out where the shaft is here. Okay, so far so good. Make sure the belt is on there properly. Beauty. There is a little nubby here you got to make sure you're on the right side of. Awesome. Don't know how much of that I blocked. The only other thing left to do is put the nylon washer back on and that little clip. I don't have a set of snap ring pliers small enough. I'm just going to try to do that by hand. Just confirming I'm in the ring all the way. Yep. Okay. So there you go. Variable speed drive pulley has been rebuilt and good to go. Probably for my lifetime anyway. Got my new belt. First thing I'm going to do, if you'll remember, I removed those two bolts from the other side for the shifter. And so the first thing I will do is feed the belt over that so that I can bolt that back up and then worry about the rest without having to worry about it. That's essentially what's going to go on. Because as I say, tripods and me just don't get along. And then what I'll do is I'll pull, just like how I took it off, and I'll pull that idler right back at that away, and everything should walk its way on. Okay, so I'll slip the whole belt under. Just to get her down there. My head's probably in the way. Okay, so now hitch is on. The good side of the shifter. I'll put those two bolts back in. You probably won't see it from here.
They don't need to be reached on crazy tight. Let me just bring it. I said, obviously, this is good enough.
There, now I don't have to worry about the shifter being in my way. And the rest should just walk on. Probably a good idea to do the big belt first from there. Mm-hmm.
Let's see, how are we going to do this?
Oh yeah. I was trying to figure out why this was seemed to have no room. I got to put it in gear. And when you release the clutch, look at that. I forgot all about that. There we go, that's a little better. I was trying to figure out why isn't it going. So, that's it. Pull your idler. And look at that. Everything's on. Not one spring had to be removed. The transmission pulley didn't have to be removed. I didn't even have to remove the front pulley because I didn't end up changing the lower belt. It seems okay, but my luck, there's probably a bad spot somewhere I can't see. But for now, voila. Everything's on. Everything should be good to go, at least on that end of things. I'm just going to do a couple of other things here and there. Sharpen the blade. And change the oil and all that other crud. Take the covers off the deck. Just to make sure there's no debris in there. The only thing I got to do now is just put the belt guard back on. Or the guide pin. Just got to put that one back on, and that'll be that. Ciao for now.